Hey Math31, welcome to my lecture videos. This is the first one we're going to be doing together. So anytime you start these, just the little headers up here, in case you forget who I am, I'm your teacher, I'm Miss Abreu. You can just call me Miss A. In case you forget what class you're in, we're in Math31, College Algebra. And this will be the section number that we're going over for this particular lecture. And in this case, we're doing section 2.1. We're going to learn about the rectangular coordinate system and some graphs. Your homework, if you go to your book, it's pages 84 to 86, and you're going to do 1 through 61 every other odd. And when it says every other odd, that means you would do 1, 5, 9, 13, 17, so on and so forth. So it's every other odd. So you know, the next number that's odd after 1 is 3. We're going to skip that, go to 5. Skip 7, go to 9. Skip 11, go to 13. So on and so forth. And keep in mind, you can find the solutions to these in Canvas for reference. And you can always email me with screenshots if you ever have any questions on homework. Or if you're in my hybrid class, we can meet face to face at some point and go over any homework questions you want. So make sure, or just know that you've got a lot of resources available to you. So the next thing that you'll see in every lecture packet is the learning outcomes. And for the most part, in chapters 2 and 3, it should be review. Maybe not all of it, but a large portion of it. So here, you see these learning outcomes, and I hope that they're familiar to you. If they're not, make sure that you're getting as much support as you need through the STEM Center or through a co-requisite class or through some friends in class, something to that effect. But my hopes is that when we read these learning outcomes for section 2.1, they're review. So we're going to plot some ordered pairs in the Cartesian coordinate system. We're going to graph equations by plotting points. We're going to graph equations with your graphing calculator. All right, because keep in mind, you do need a graphing calculator for this class. You need either a TI-83 or a TI-84, those are required. And you can rent them from the STEM Center or from me. We're gonna review how to find X and Y intercepts. We're gonna make sure we know how to use the distance formula and use the midpoint formula. All right, and the first learning outcome here was talking about the Cartesian coordinate system and plotting ordered pairs. So I'm gonna scooch the paper up and we're gonna get a look at the Cartesian coordinate system and a brief history lesson. And then we're gonna start plotting some ordered pairs and picking up some vocab. All right, so let me move this to the top and we will get going. Okay, so moving through this. All right, the Cartesian coordinate system. A coordinate system is formed by two number lines called axes that intersect at their zero points, which we call the origin. The axes separate the coordinate planes into four regions called quadrants. The horizontal line is called the x-axis, and the vertical line is called the y-axis. So at some point in your math careers, you would have seen this graph before. So we've got our x-axis here, horizontal, right? Our y-axis here is vertical. And right here in the middle, all right, where they're intersecting at their zero points, that is the origin. They're labeling it O here. And here's Q1, Q2, Q3, and Q4, or the four quadrants, 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, and we call it the Cartesian coordinate system because back in the 17th century, René Descartes was a French philosopher in the 17th century who is credited with inventing this graphing system. So that's why it's called the Cartesian coordinate system. And maybe you've never even heard it called the Cartesian coordinate system. You just call it your axes, your XY axes. Great. But that's the history behind it, or the brief history behind it. All right, so I'm going to scoot this up just a little bit more, so we can see some of the extra vocab that we're gonna be talking about in here. So a point on the plane is defined as an ordered pair x, y, such that x is determined by the horizontal distance from the origin, and y is determined by its vertical distance from the origin. Any point on the coordinate system is described by an ordered pair, such as negative 5, 4. And I specifically picked negative 5, 4 because that's coordinate P up here. And you can see in terms of negative 5, I go left 5, right? So I'm going an x distance from this origin. And because it's negative, I'm going to go left. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And my y coordinate here is 4, so I'm going to go up 1, 2, 3, 4. So this negative 5, 4 corresponds with this point P. All right, so again, any point P on the coordinate system is described by an ordered pair, such as negative 5, 4. In this ordered pair, negative 5 is the x-coordinate, and 4 is the y-coordinate. If you put a dot on the coordinate system at the point described by negative 5, 4, you are plotting the point. This dot is the graph of the point. All right, so that's just a little bit of vocab. We're gonna flip to the example one, and we're gonna take a look at how you plot or how you graph an ordered pair on the coordinate system. All right, I'll see you in a bit, bye. Hey guys, welcome back. So we're gonna take a look at our first example, and I just wanna point out that there's this phrase up here that's in bold, right? Plot ordered pairs in the Cartesian coordinate system. And if that sounds a little bit familiar, great. It has to do with this very first learning outcome from back on page one, where it says plot ordered pairs in the Cartesian coordinate system. So as you progress through every one of these packets, for every learning outcome that's listed on the front page, there's a corresponding bolded phrase that matches it, right? Plot ordered pairs in the Cartesian coordinate system. And every example that follows it is just an example that demonstrates this learning outcome. So we're first going to take a look at an example that shows us how to plot ordered pairs in the Cartesian coordinate system. So here is our example. It says use the coordinate system to the right, graph A, which is the ordered pair 2, negative 4 on the coordinate system. What is the ordered pair for the point Q on the coordinate system? Okay, so if I take a look here, I've got my basic coordinate system. X and Y is labeled. I see the scale, and I'm going to mention that repeatedly. Always make sure you're labeling your axes, and always make sure you're putting a scale here, telling me that this one square represents one unit, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I could just as easily have labeled this 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, or whatever scale you want, but make sure you communicate that to me. All right, so it looks like we've got the first point at 2, -4. So these always come as an ordered pair x comma y. And alphabetically, x comes before y, and it's the same deal in our coordinate system, or in our ordered pairs. So as I look at this, my x coordinate is 2. So x's always move you left, right. Y's always move you up, down. All right, and when your x is positive, you move right. X is negative, you move left. If y is positive, you move up. If y is negative, you move down. And those are your four directions, right? Right, left, up, and down. So let's take a look at how we're gonna move. It says x is 2, positive 2, so I'm gonna move to the right by 2. So you see from my origin, I went 1, 2 units to the right. Now my y coordinate is negative 4. Y's move me up, down. So I'm gonna move down 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And there is ordered pair A. Okay, so then let's take a look at this next one. It says, what is the ordered pair for the point Q on the coordinate system? Well, here's Q and here's the origin. All right, so how did I get from the origin to Q, either moving left, right, or up, down? Well, first of all, I can see horizontally I moved to the left. I've gotta move my pencil this way to get to Q. And I needed to go 1, 2, 3 units left. So for Q, my x coordinate would be negative 3. All right. Now from here, I needed to move down. So I needed to go down 2 units, 1, 2. And since I'm moving down, my y coordinate would be negative as well. So Q is the ordered pair negative 3, negative 2. And just to point out, just so we remember something from the front page, point A is over here, right? So this is in Q4. I know they didn't ask us for the quadrant, but why not? All right, and point Q, if you look, it's in quadrant 1, 2, 3. So just for a little piece of extra information, point A is in fourth quadrant, point Q is in the third quadrant. All right, so with that, let's move on to example 2. I'll see you in a few, bye.